prologue. Dear listener, I would not have believed it if I hadn't done it for myself. You can actually write an ebook without actually doing the writing. Because of an interesting legal twist, you can hire a writer, and then when the writer is finished, you own the complete copyright to the work. If it sounds too good to be true, it almost is. But there's something else that's almost too good to be true. Having an ebook written doesn't cost near what it costs to have a hardcover book written. It's actually pretty affordable for someone who plans to recoup their money with ebook sales. One more almost too good to be true fact: ebooks often sell for the same price that a traditional, hold it in your hand, book would sell for. No writing, no problem. Let me tell you a little about my story. As the internet began taking over the world, dollar signs flashed almost constantly in the back of my mind. I did some research to see who was making money from this evolution. I ran across import companies, search engines, website development / hosting companies, and auction sites. That was a year ago. Now, more than ever, the internet is starting to define business. People are actually paying for and downloading songs for their listening pleasure. People are researching, planning, and booking entire vacations online. People who love information are inhaling the internet. Information is everywhere. Of course, that presents a bit of a dilemma. Information overload. Part of the problem with researching the internet is the information you glean during your surfing is highly, if not completely, unorganized. You do a Google search. You notice there are thousands of pages relevant to your search terms. So, you narrow your search by adding a word or two. Now you're down to several hundred pages. And you start clicking on them, one after the other. On to the next problem of up-popping pop-ups. Darn those things. By the time you close all the windows, you may have very well forgotten why you sat down at the computer in the first place. Even on sites without pop-ups, you really don't know what exactly you're going to get or whether or not the source is reliable. So, the internet is like a feast with some of the options being spoiled. Yuck. But the buffet is intriguing, so most of us tend to return to try our luck again and again. Anyway, all this got me to thinking, what about ebooks? Yeah, sure, you can read Charles Dickens on a computer, but I'm talking about ebooks that teach, in a non-fiction sort of way. If I could put a few good ebooks on the web, then maybe people who wanted to learn about a topic could read an entire book from a reputable source online. So I tried it. And guess what? At first I didn't have much success. But I dusted myself off, studied, tried again, and tried again. Eventually, through trial and error mostly, I stumbled on a formula that worked. This book was born well after all of that, but I think it's high time I share my experience. There's plenty of room on the internet for everyone. Climb aboard. There are some hobbies that seem to continually attract enthusiasts, like playing golf, watching football, restoring old cars, and listening to music. These are classics. Then there are some hobbies that seem to come and go in waves, such as Red Hat Society's participation, snowboarding, or line dancing. Pick either a classic hobby or a fluctuating hobby and it's peak season for your best odds. A big market on the internet is the 20-30 set. Here's what they are doing right now, according to one survey. They're snowboarding, wakeboarding, traveling, camping, listening to music, taking photographs. They're drinking gourmet coffee, rock climbing, playing guitar, camping, dancing, looking for online love, shopping for computers and other electronics, attending sports events, studying the Bible, exercising, trying to find jobs, and watching movies. Any one of these subjects would make a great ebook with a buying market standing by. How-tos and hot topics. There is almost no limit whatsoever on the marketability of how-to books. Everyone wants an instruction manual, advice, and encouragement that they can do anything they read a how-to book for. Anything you know how to do, anything you've ever wanted to learn, or anything that's teachable at all, can become a how-to ebook. How-to books for hobbyists are a good way to go, and this overlaps with the discussion above. A hobby how-to ebook could be anything from how to build a home from hay bales to how to play Texas Hold'em to how to understand Shakespeare. One book publisher knows how hungry we are for how-to information, and has created a whole series of dummies books around the market. Further, there are other similar book series, and all of them are doing quite well. The Everything series, Idiot's Guide series and others are all cashing in on the how-to phenomenon. You could cash in by creating ebooks on any or all subjects covered in any of those series. Go to www.dummies.com and check out their list of titles. Pick one you like, and move full speed ahead. Remember that even though the books have dummies in the title, that the books are as popular as they are because the readers are not treated like dummies at all. The authors cater to a person who wants to find out the easiest way to do something without too much tangential discussion. When you have your ebook written and when you choose a title, make sure you are appealing to a reader's smarts. If you use words like stupid, dumb, or hopeless in the title, make sure that it is clear that the meaning would not extend to insulting the individual reader. Ebooks, because of their brevity and because they are marketed primarily on the internet, can target smaller audiences. You don't have to write a universal book like How to Use a Computer, which may not be interesting enough to sell anyway in this decade. Ebooks can cover more specific territory. Knowing this, you can 1. Create your ebook in a specific way for a specific niche readership, and 2. Create additional ebooks for different facets of the same subject, and sell each one separately. Say you've decided to write an ebook on fishing. FYI, this is one of those hobbies where enthusiasts are willing to spend money. You could create How to Catch Freshwater Trout, How to Tie Your Own Flies, or How to Plan a Successful Deep-Sea Fishing Trip. Almost anything related to the hobby can become a separate ebook depending on how much detail you include. Clearly, How to Put on Waders probably wouldn't be a great choice, though some would say it's impossible to underestimate today's consumer, because you would have to strain to fill up 60 to 100 pages on such a simple topic. You get the idea. The topic would need to be, in most cases, bookworthy. Use good judgment. Then, life itself requires instructions, as we know from Life's Little Instruction Book. So, life also qualifies as a good how-to book topic. There are numerous subtopics, and you'll never run out of ideas. Here are a few examples: how to ensure your child gets an A+ in math, how to have a successful garage sale, how to organize your home office, and while we're on the subject of how-to books, I'd like to make one quick point. The titles of these ebooks do not need to be incredibly clever. Be sure the words how-to are the first part of the title, and the rest should tell exactly what the ebook is about. For example, which of these three titles would be best? 1. How to Have a Successful Garage Sale. 2. 1 Weekend Away from a Cleaner House. 3. How to Sell Your Old Shoes for a Profit. Although numbers 2 and 3 are clever, a little punchy, and correspond with the ebook content, I would still recommend using title number 1. How to Have a Successful Garage Sale sums it up pretty well and will catch the eye of an internet surfer who is interested in putting together a garage sale and needs a how-to manual. Anyway, back to the point. Any phase of life, way of coping with life, or a large or small thing about life can be the subject of a how-to book. Looking young, perhaps 16-year-old girls don't want to look younger, but from that point on, and for most of the population in Western society, looking young is a common desire. Everybody wants to find the fountain of youth, whether it be in a pill bottle, a special diet, surgery, or an ebook. An ebook about staying or appearing young in the face of growing old will have a solid future. Here are some title ideas, and I'm sure you can come up with a truckload more. Drop 10 years and 10 pounds in 10 days, How to Look 28 Forever, 100 Ways to Look Younger, Grocery Store Products That Will Help You Look Younger, Look 30 Again Without Surgery, How to Live to Be 100. This topic is red hot. Botox, surgery, chemical peels, lasers, diets, acupuncture, electronic pulses, mega vitamins, prescription teas, thigh cream, and teeth whiteners are being purchased by baby boomers, the elderly, and even women as young as 20. No one wants to look a day older than they have to. Health is a concern to anyone who is growing old or ill or faced illness with a loved one or wants more energy or, basically, everybody. Healthy books are a good investment for you to make. And doctors don't have to be the authors. Anyone with any credentials, or no credentials at all, can write books on health. Just be sure you don't claim to be a doctor if you're not one. Here are some health topics you can hit at this moment in time and be almost guaranteed immediate interest, readership, and sales. Disease prevention and cure. As our baby boomer population ages, most will be afflicted with heart disease, cancer, diabetes, dementia, or some other malady. Give these people some hope. Create an ebook on how to cope, how to find the best practitioners, how to avoid disease triggers, or cures American doctors are unaware of. Natural remedies. People are curious about alternatives to standard medicine, and are anxious to try herbal, natural, or holistic treatments. Create a book on any disease that covers alternative cures. For example, how to treat lymphoma, naturally. Or, you could just address natural supplements in general, the best natural remedies for common ailments, or holistic health. Diet. What we eat is always a hot topic. There are literally dozens if not hundreds of diet fads currently out there. Pick any one of them for an ebook. Then there's obesity, general health, and also diet supplements like vitamins. Think how to equip your kitchen for macrobiotic dieting. Or, Eat to Cure Cancer. Chapter 1 How to Select a Great Topic. It couldn't be easier to select a topic for an ebook. People are hungry for information, and people are looking to the internet to feed their hunger. After you've read this chapter, you will feel confident enough to choose your own topic, or you can literally pull your ebook topic directly from this ebook and use it. How's that for a deal? Observe what's going on around you. If you're smart enough to read this book, you're smart enough to look around you and determine what interests you and those around you. Think of what problems you've recently solved, and what kinds of problems others have had and solved. Any problem that has been solved in your world could easily be the subject of your next book. People love to read how others have solved a problem that they currently have. So, brainstorm a list of problems in your life and in the lives of those around you. Your friend Bob lost his job. Your sister's child had chicken pox. How did they cope or find solutions? While you're at it, start another list of unsolved problems evident in your corner of the world. Write down problems you wish you had solved. Aha! These are subjects that people will really be interested in. How to lose the last 10 pounds. The truth about UFOs. The straightest path to becoming a millionaire. From your personal corner, your step-granddaughter is pregnant at age 14. Your grocery bill is double what it used to be. Your roof leaks. These are problems waiting for ebook solutions. These unsolved problems would also be great ebook topics. Remember, you don't have to know the solution, just the topic. You're going to get someone else to do the research and write the book for you. You will not actually be writing one word. Spend a few minutes Googling the internet is a great way to find out what people are looking for at any given moment. You can search for almost anything. Google it is a popular search engine you can use, or you can try any of the others like Yahoo! Exclamation mark registered or mama.com. Type in phrases like top concerns of Americans, best-selling non-fiction topics, or popular how-to manuals. Common worries of 2005. And while you're on the internet, find out the most popular non-fiction books from the New York Times bestseller list, Amazon, and a Google search for ebooks. Your findings will tell you exactly what book subjects people are buying right now. Try this. Go to www.amazon.com. From the tabbed menu running along the top of the Amazon homepage, click Top Sellers. I did this one day in September 2005 and found a Harry Potter book, several other fiction books, and titles such as Natural Cures They Won't Tell You About, How What You Wear Can Change Your Life, How to Profit from the Demise of the Dollar, and the Official SAT Study Guide. I've paraphrased to some degree, but you get the idea. Here's what I learned just from spending a few minutes on Amazon that day. People are reading good fiction from already best-selling authors, Da Vinci Code, the Harry Potter series, and others. Secondly, Amazon buyers, buying over the internet, are interested in non-fiction topics such as improving their lives and making more money. For these books, just about any author will do, even virtual unknowns or people who went to prison for lying to the American public. And that quick visit only confirmed that the straightest route to ebook profits is in the non-fiction ebook market. This is for a number of reasons. Fiction readers tend to like to curl up in a chair with an actual book. Some of them attend book clubs where the physical books are brought around someone's kitchen table with wine and cheese. Fiction readers tend to purchase from authors they're already familiar with. Fiction can be more difficult to write and deliver well. Also, many of the classics in fiction are available as free ebooks. A reader interested in fiction could just download those. So stick with nonfiction unless you're feeling particularly bold and experimental. Here is some more good news, and if you didn't already know this, then you are going to be smiling big. Drum roll, please. Ideas are not copyrighted, therefore any idea you see, hear, or read anywhere anytime, is yours to use for an ebook. You can create books around the same ideas that are covered in the Amazon bestseller list, and turn around and create an ebook on the exact same subject. Now, copyright law does protect the way ideas are expressed, so you want to make sure your hired author does not plagiarize or copy book text outright. And you cannot use the title word for word either. But there's nothing stopping you from creating another book or ebook that covers the same subject with a different voice. It's all as completely legal and guilt-free as non-fat Haagen-Dazs. This is why looking at bestseller lists is a great way to get topic ideas. Digging a little deeper, there are groups of people who are willing to buy non-fiction ebooks, hobbyists. At any given time, these people are looking for ways to spend their money on their hobbies. Their passion is your financial gain. What avid hobbyists want will always make great ebook material. Note that I did not say what hobbyists need. You may have certain opinions on what exactly certain people should need or should read. But those are not necessarily good topics for immediate ebook profit. Those topics may be areas for you to dabble in at your leisure. However, if you want to make money at this, find out what niche groups want, and hit those groups with your ebook. Find hobbyists and niche groups by searching the web for popular hobbies, enthusiasts, or what America is buying. Or, you can search specifically for forums and discussion groups for hobbyists. In the forums, people talk with each other to share ideas with one another. Often, they will exchange testimonials for equipment, upcoming events, and books. One popular site where hobbyists go to talk to one another online is Yahoo. Check it out. Go to www.yahoo.com. Click Groups. On the Groups page, you'll see a list of categories such as business and finance, and religion. For demonstration purposes, click on Games. On the Games screen, game subcategories are listed followed by numbers. The numbers indicate how many discussion forums are available for that subcategory. These numbers reveal a lot. Notice how role-playing games, and video and computer games have factors of 10 or in some cases factors of 100 more forums than other subcategories. Wargaming and paintball don't even come close, although those categories are much more discussion-laden than horseshoe pitching. For fun, one day I continued selecting subcategories until I arrived at a list of over 1,000, yes 1,000, discussion groups on Yahoo having to do with vampire role-playing. Here's how I got there: games role-playing games, live-action World of Darkness Vampire, The Masquerade. Some of the forums are open to new members, and you can join to read what everyone's discussing. Once in the forum, you can review discussion threads from today, yesterday, or a year ago. Don't go back too far if you want to find out the hottest possible ebook topics. You can participate in discussions if you like. FYI, do not drop into a discussion group just to market an ebook. Hobbyists consider this spam and will drop you from the group. When you read and/or participate, you'll find out what this group is buying. All you have to do is skim to find out what questions they are asking each other about products or traveling or information. What they are interested in buying is a key piece of information because passionate consumers love to research before they buy. This is an immediate ebook market. Create a book on how to select the best this or that on the market, related to the current wants of the enthusiasts. Enthusiasts come in all shapes and sizes. Think brides-to-be, golfers, whitewater rafters, people who collect vintage baseball cards, wine connoisseurs, gardeners, frequent vacationers, video gamers, and parents who put their children into private tutoring, ballet, and violin lessons before age 3. Travel never has so much travel been available to so many. People today want to get in touch with the people they love. They want to experience different parts of the world. See exotic things. Be entertained. Also, because, especially in America, adults sometimes work well more than 40 hours a week, people need really good vacations. They're doing their research to make sure that they will really enjoy their precious few weeks off each year. Here are some topics for you: how to trade frequent flyer miles, how to keep airport security off your back, how to travel on a dime and get change, and how to keep your children happy on long car trips. Beyond the how-tos, there is plenty of room for books like The Best Amusement Parks for Your Money, Top 100 Campgrounds, Things You Must See and Do in Utah Before You Die, and Free Things to Do When Visiting Washington, D.C. Get the idea? The good thing about creating travel ebooks is that you may already know a lot about a place that other people may be interested in visiting. Makes it easy. Money makes the world go around, well, that and the Earth's axis and planetary forces, and so it would make sense that ebooks would abound on the topic of money. They do, but the market is nowhere near saturated. There's always room for more. From getting rich to just saving money day to day, people are always interested in how-to books related to money. Ideas below: how to feed your family on less than $40 a week, how to get free stuff, how to pay almost no taxes, how to buy a retirement home for no money down, how to be richer than your parents, how to buy cars at auction, how to start a financial management business. Life enrichment in these days, although fewer and fewer are attending churches, more and more are flocking to purchase self-help books. Self-help books are leaping off shelves at brick-and-mortar bookstores. People want to feel that if they read a self-help book, they have all the power to change their lives. Whether or not this is true is moot. Changing your life, soul-searching, and helping thyself are all great ebook topics. As much as ever before, people want to know how to find peace with their pasts, how to be creative or spiritual in a consuming society, and how to find true love. There is no end to how-to books you could create in the category of self-help or life enrichment. Here are a few more ideas here: how to marry for life, how to unbreak your heart, how to stay sane in a crazy world, how to meditate. A few more topics bound to explode. These are fiery hot topics that are sure to be on the rise. You can pull any one of these to use for your first ebook. Then come back and pull another topic for your next ebook. Using the latest electronics. We are a society obsessed with having the latest and greatest technology. Do an ebook on iPods, email, camera, cell phones, wireless internet, digital TV, or any combination of these items. Home improvement. There's so much of a craze in this area that do-it-yourself, DIY, stores are on every corner of major cities. If you haven't been to a Home Depot or Lowe's lately, then you are one of the few. Sure, apartment dwellers and young students aren't in this market, but people with homes and money to afford them are in this market. In fact, some cable TV services offer entire channels dedicated to home improvement. Especially of current interest are in-home automation systems. DIY home improvers are eager to learn about and buy things that will make their home lives more relaxing, high-tech, or fun. Create a book to teach them how to make their lights come on for them before they get home from their jobs, or how to press a button to adjust window blinds, music, or temperature. Or how Bill Gates' house works. Or how to add automation to an existing home. Or how to build an automation when a house is constructed. Identity theft prevention. Especially because ebooks are marketed on the internet, this is a great topic. This is because people who purchase over the internet are concerned that their credit card numbers will not be seen by others or misused in any way. Even away from the computer though, consumers are on edge about identity theft. Today, people are shredding their receipts, removing their personal information from the face of their checks, and cautiously covering themselves when they type in passwords at public terminals or ATMs. Microchips are being installed on ID cards. People are worried. Tap into this with an ebook. Safety. Along the same lines as worrying about identity theft, people are worried about their safety from other things like crime, chemical warfare attack, and natural disasters. Watch the evening news tonight, and you will be able to list at least 20 things that people are afraid of. When you talk about safety, you are speaking their language. Titles along the lines of "Be prepared for any natural disaster" would go over well, as would those like "Never be a crime victim again," "How to defend yourself in a parking lot," or "Prevent sudden infant death syndrome," SIDS. How to manuals for any new product recently on the market. This harks back to the Dummies series but takes it one step further. Target your ebook to people who want to buy the most current commercially available item. How to use the new model John Deere tractor. You will be sure that no one else has a book like yours, and you can say so in your sales pitch. How to survive any phase of life. People face numerous demons and battles as they live their lives. For many, when they're in need, they'll be reaching out for help. Support groups, private therapy, being with friends, starting over, these are all solid topics for an ebook. You could also reach out specifically to certain people needing emotional assistance. How to get through the terrible twos. How to cope with a cancer diagnosis. Living with your own shortcomings. How to live with someone who is dying. Surviving high school. Any of these will do. Anything to do with pets. People are pampering their pets more than ever before. Some pets are treated better than people. It's the people who spend small fortunes on their pets that will also be willing to pay good money for an ebook that gives them ideas on how to treat their animals even more royally than they already do. Write books on how to pamper your parakeet, homemade meals for picky dogs, where their pet spas are, how to train your kids to be cat-friendly, million-dollar homes for mutts, which animals make the best pets, or pet psychology. Traveling mixed with the subjects above. Not only are people traveling like crazy, but they want to customize their itineraries and their methods of travel with their hobbies and lifestyles. Try a few of these on for size: where to dine around the globe and still stay on a low-carb diet plan. Hotels with the best exercise facilities. How to travel exquisitely with large dogs. Crime-proof your campsite. Be creative. There's a market here. Using the internet to meet people. As I said, the craze is upon us. Everyone's online, and sometimes folks spend more time chatting with internet buddies than they do talking face-to-face with actual friends. I know I've been guilty of this one myself. Anyway, along with the advent of the World Wide Web, came people who need a little help figuring out how to get where they want to get. They want to find like-minded people, find a date, find love, find support. There's a huge ebook market for hooking people up with people online. Here are just a few things that could be covered: speed dating online, virtual music jams, taking online classes, hooking up with people who share your hobby, and finding online support groups. Any of these and more are of interest to people who wish to get maximum benefit from their ability, thanks to the internet, to network with people in the farthest reaches of the world. In fact, one of the appeals with online communing is that distance does not matter. Help these people in foreign lands find each other with an ebook. Topics of special interest to women. The facts don't lie. Women dominate the internet, and they spend or influence spending of 80 cents for every dollar changing hands. What women want has never been so important to business owners and authors. Certain topics appeal particularly to the female set. These include beauty, health, decorating, emotional support, and life enrichment. Women do a few things, generally, that men don't. They play bunco, wear makeup, and talk for hours to their girlfriends on the phone. They send more greeting cards, prepare more casseroles, and vacuum more often than men. They eat more salads and go shopping more often for clothes. They get more pedicures and love to dance more than the average man. There are two things to keep in mind with regards to women and e-books. If you want to attract a female market, you need to write about a topic that women like to read about, and you want to make the title friendly towards women. Here's a female-oriented subject and title: where to find great shopping bargains in Taos. And here's a male subject: where to catch the most fish in Taos. Here's a female-friendly title, same as above: where to find great shopping bargains in Taos. And here's a male-friendly title on the same subject: keep your money in your pocket in Taos. See the difference? Know your market, and if you need to choose between one or the other, you're safe going with the women's title. Sex. People don't need to sneak out of bookstores with erotic books in their hands anymore, and they know it. They are looking on the internet for sex materials, toys, and books. The internet is private, individuals can take their sweet time, and indeed they can surf with or without a lover sharing their chair. There's been a recent ebook success entitled Orgasms for Two. There is room for more similar ebooks. On the subject of sex, this is one case where a fiction book may also do the trick. You could create erotic short stories or a How to Have Great Sex ebook. Either ebook would entice adults interested in this category, and incidentally, most adults are indeed interested in this category. Chapter 2: Where to Find Great Writers. When you hire for a writer for your ebook, what you are doing is enlisting the services of a ghostwriter. A ghostwriter is a writer who publishes under someone else's name, with the consent of both parties. Traditionally, ghostwriters have been and are still today hired by celebrities to write autobiographies when the celebrities are not talented writers. Ghostwriters also sometimes create works for well-known authors, such as Tom Clancy. This practice is done for business reasons, because the author's name alone will sell the books, no matter who actually wrote them. Ghostwriters may also write for book series that don't actually have a real person author. An example of a series written this way is the Hardy Boys series you may remember from your youth. The Hardy Boys cover author, Franklin W. Dixon, does not actually exist. Many romance novel series have also been created in this way, where the author name on the cover represents any number or variety of commissioned writers. With the advent of the internet and e-books, today, ghostwriters also write e-books. When you outsource your e-book to a ghostwriter, you are giving them the job of creating the words in your e-book in exchange for a fee. You still get to put your own author name on the finished product. Ultimately, you will own the copyright, and you can sell the ebook as many times as you like. If it sounds like a pretty nice arrangement, it is. It's all completely legal and commonly done. And you do not have to be a celebrity or Tom Clancy to hire one. Great things about ghostwriters: just because a ghostwriter does the writing does not mean that you do not deserve to be the credited author. You will be the originator of the idea, and provide direction to the ghostwriter, so that the written material reflects what you want it to say. You may also create a pen name for yourself if you wish your real name to remain anonymous to casual readers. Once you hand off the reins to a ghostwriter to prepare an ebook for you, you may never go back and try to write one yourself ever again. A ghostwriter can do so many things for you, from researching to editing. And any writer knows that the process of writing and polishing a book or an ebook takes a significant amount of time. Much more than most readers will ever know. Start to finish writing is a large task best left to those who love their jobs, who are willing to spend the time writing and rewriting incessantly until things are just right, and who has talent and experience in the craft. What they can do, you can outsource more than just rote writing to a ghostwriter. In fact, ghostwriters can be hired to research your topic fully on the internet or elsewhere. They can then translate your or their research into organized sections and create palatable, conversational paragraphs for your readers. They can interview people that you designate or that they seek out for the ebook. They can separate the ebook-worthy material from non-ebook-worthy material for inclusion, with an eye on what readers are interested in and what you have hired them to write about. In other words, good ghostwriters will stay on the topic as they write and not veer off into irrelevant tangents. It's actually an art form in itself to be able to insert quips and images that are designed to hold a reader's interest while quickly and smoothly getting back on track to deliver the information promised by the title and table of contents. Speaking of the table of contents, an experienced ghostwriter can review rough notes from you and propose a title and table of contents. Ghostwriters can start from notes, organize the material into an outline, generate a table of contents, research and add filling text, make boring information flow like an entertaining conversation, and more. They can basically start with whatever you've got to start with and get you from there to a completed ebook. If you have already tried your hand at preparing an ebook, a ghostwriter can whip your existing draft ebook into sellable shape. She can review the content, make suggestions, do necessary research, add new sections, repair grammar, or revise any not quite perfect portions of the ebook. In fact, It has been known to happen sometimes that one ghostwriter will be hired to edit another ghostwriter's work. This may be done in a case where you are not satisfied with the result from the first ghostwriter, or can also be done if you just want to polish your product. Going on the two heads are better than one philosophy. She can use a writing style and language that is appropriate for the book. Should it be in first person like this ebook is? Or perhaps it would work better in third person like many reference books are written. Should it be written from a female or male perspective? Ghostwriters will accommodate your preferences, and if you don't know your preferences, ghostwriters can help you make those decisions. She can put the ebook into the format that you choose. If you want your pages to appear the size of regular notebook paper, about 8.5 inches by 11 inches, then the writer can prepare the manuscript to fit. If you like large margins, where the text appears in between in a narrower column, the ghostwriter can do that. Narrow column ebooks are popular and easy on the eyes. If you like a blank page preceding chapters, ask for that. For items such as page dimensions, font, and layout, she can make recommendations. She can also, in most cases, provide you the electronic file type that you prefer: MS Word, WordPerfect, Adobe Acrobat, Internet HTML, or other, or make suggestions to you on format. Finally, good ghostwriters can write quickly. Ghostwriters cannot perform miracles, but it's not unheard of to get an ebook done in 30 days when you need it fast. Depending on your need and schedule, you can usually find some who will work even more quickly. It's nice to allow 6 weeks, but not necessary. You can sit back while your ebook is being written. All you need to do is give the ghostwriter the information and he can get straight to work. You may provide any level of detail on your title or topic, your notions, if any, on how the topic should be covered, and any other relevant information. Most of the communication can take place by email, and that keeps things pretty simple and also well documented. You may, if you prefer, talk by phone or use regular mail. It's not common or necessary to meet face to face with your writer to get her rolling on your project. This is because ebooks tend to be on tighter schedules and lower budgets than ghostwritten books or books. It will save time, money, and any confusion if you try to use email and the internet as your primary tools to communicate with your writer. Ghostwriters are invaluable resources. Time is money, and you want to spend your time elsewhere: marketing, thinking of new ideas, relaxing at the beach. Ghostwriting is definitely the way to go. The general advantages are that outsourcing the actual writing of the book is not too expensive, commonly done, it's legal and writers are available to provide the service, and you can direct your energy somewhere else while the book is being written. In the end, you'll still own the written words, and can do whatever you want with them. Indeed, you can even edit and revise them yourself. Next, I'll talk about finding those available ebook ghostwriters and touch also on pricing. Where ghostwriters lurk. You can find ghostwriters the hard way or the easy way. The hard way is to locate writing or authoring organizations in cities around the globe, and interview writers until you find one that you believe is qualified to write your book. The easy way to find a ghostwriter is to go to an internet site where ghostwriters are hanging out, ready to respond to classified ads. You place an ad for your project, and you wait for bids to come in. Two large sites with gobs of ghostwriter of traffic are Elance and Guru. A third way is to contact ghostwriting companies directly. Of the avenues available, I recommend going through one of the large sites that have high ghostwriter traffic. Sometimes these types of sites are called freelancer databases, ghostwriter banks, freelancer job banks, or similar. Get ghostwriters competing for your ebook. The two large online freelancer databases where ghostwriters lurk that I mentioned above, Elance and Guru, operate in essentially the same way. Basically, you post an ad and wait for responses. You choose a writer from the list of responders, agree on a schedule and fee, and then move on and do something else until your ebook arrives to you in your email inbox. Both sites maintain catalogs of people who provide freelance services. The Elance catalog has over 50,000 people listed. Some of the people in the catalog, or bank, provide software programming or other service. Not everyone in the bank is a ghostwriter. So when you get to the site, you'll need to navigate to the area that applies to ebooks and ghostwriting. Although this may take you a few minutes at first, the site is easily navigable once you get your bearings. Let's walk through Elance. Go to www.elance.com. From the home page, scroll down to the menu along the bottom of the page, and click on Marketplace. From the Marketplace page, look to the left-hand side of the screen, and from that menu, click on Writing and Translation. If the site organization has changed slightly since this writing, just use common sense and navigate around until you find the ebook project's database. Basically, you are looking for the area where you can advertise that you want to outsource an ebook to a ghostwriter. Click around until you get there. To make things easier on future visits, when you find ebook outsourcing services, add that URL to your internet browser's favorites list. Tip: writers are referred to as service providers on Elance. This phrase is not to be confused with an internet service provider, ISP, or the service of the Elance website itself. On Guru, writers are referred to as registered professionals. In Elance's writing marketplace, browse through others' ads to see how they are finding ghostwriters, and roughly what the projects are paying. With a quick browse, you can see how ads are written and which ghostwriters have responded, and additional details about the advertisers and the ghostwriter responder. Placing ads is free as of this writing. The ghostwriters are the ones who pay to review the ads. Isn't that nice? You will need to subscribe, however, and get some of your information into the database in order to advertise. This is only fair so that responders know what they are responding to and so that there is trust that payment will be made when the job is completed. I recommend that you subscribe right away, so that the processing can take place while you're getting your other pre-work done, selecting a topic for your ebook and creating your ad for posting. Once you place an ad, writers will begin to post online bids for your project. They may offer to write your ebook for less money than the maximum pay you stated in your ad, or they may offer to write the ebook more quickly than you've stated you require. Basically, they start a friendly competition, usually friendly, to get your business. Lots of them will be appealing. That's because it's a buyer's market, good news for you. Each responder will provide some background information along with their offer. There will be navigable links you can click on to review their history with Elance, their portfolio, and ratings given by some of their clients. Unsubscribed web surfers will not have access to all the detail that you do on the ghostwriters. Likewise, casual surfers will not have access to all of your ads' details either. From the bids you get, you read up on the materials available and make a selection. Once you've awarded the project to a writer, you'll work up an agreement between you and the writer, and arrange payment through Elance. There are agreement templates you can use on the site, and there are recommended methods of paying also. You may want to browse through some of this information early on regarding scheduling and payment, even before you place your ad, to make sure you understand the fine print. There's nothing terrible there that I know of, but read it all anyway because it's the smart thing to do. Payment can be made before the writing starts, after the writing is completed, or half before and half after the writing is completed. When you do pay, a percentage will be taken by Elance. This fee is currently less than 10% and is considered a finder's fee. Basically, you won't pay anything to your ghostwriter or to the databank service until you have actually selected a writer. Guru operates similarly. You can visit www.guru.com to find the company's agreements, paying procedures, and finder's fee amounts. The homepage of Guru lists categories of freelancers available. You will want to head directly to the writing/editing/translation category list on Guru. Currently, there's a fee structure at Guru that varies depending on what type of subscription freelancers or service companies have purchased. Some freelancers can list basic skills and respond to some ads for free. Paid members and companies will have higher profiles and be able to bid more frequently. To post a ghostwriter wanted ad is free. You will still have the power to peruse the entire catalog and invite certain service providers to bid on your project. The finder's fees range from 5 to 10%, and the finder's fees are pulled from the buyer and/or the seller at Guru. Guru is a larger site that has won some awards and has a catalog of hundreds of thousands of service providers in their database. Like with Elance, only a fraction of the service providers are ghostwriters looking for ebook work though. But a fraction of almost 500,000 is a good number. Because of the buyer's market, your odds are pretty good for finding someone quickly on the internet. Postings for ghostwriter wanted are a factor of 10 fewer than the number of authors that may bid on the job. This is regardless of monthly fees and percentages charged to the writers on the sites. Sometimes there's also a fee per bid charge for service providers. Since many ghostwriters who will be responding to your ad are already out of pocket monetarily, they're eager for your project. And they are serious about their business. The information available about each service provider, i.e. ghostwriter, can be compared to information available on vendors on the popular eBay auction site. Histories and rankings on the large sites are readily available for each writer or company you are thinking of hiring. You can see if other clients have been satisfied with a writer's work, and see how many ebooks a ghostwriter has written through the use of the freelancer bank. These indicators can be very helpful when it comes time to make a selection, and I'll talk more about how to choose a writer in the next chapter. There is another freelance database on the web where ghostwriters lurk, sometimes called All Freelance. There, ebook creators have been known to find ghostwriters using a procedure similar to the ones at Elance or Guru. Ads are placed, and freelance writers respond with bids. I don't like the site myself because of the irritating pop-ups. But it's got some traffic. If you'd like to check it out, swing by www.howfreelance.com. But don't say I didn't or knew about the pop-ups. I'm a busy man, focused on what I want to get done, and therefore I personally don't generally return to pop-up sites, as you may be able to tell by now. If you don't want the project details public, you may not wish to reveal your one-of-a-kind ebook subject or title to just anybody in what amounts to a classified ad. But you still want to attract competing ghostwriters to your interesting project. Here's what you can do. Both of the freelance database sites provide a mechanism for you to post some information in your ad that only the paid subscribers can see. This is a good way to go, and you'll see during your initial browse of others' ads that many advertisers do this. You'll see a symbol next to the project listing that indicates some of the detail is locked from public view. Already, portions of the ads are hidden from public view, and extra locking reduces the visible portions even further. Also, you can be vague in your ad. There's no need to list your title, ideas of chapters, or even the precise nature of the subject matter. In your ad, you can call your project a business ebook, if you like. When you hire a ghostwriter, you will of course need to deliver the particulars so that they can do a great job for you. Even then, it's common to have the writer sign a confidentiality agreement. So, basically, don't worry too much about someone else seeing your idea before your ebook is done. The threat of an ebook idea or title being stolen is not really that high, although as mentioned earlier, ideas are not copyrighted, so someone could rightfully go running off with your idea. The truth is, any reader of your book or related sales website could swipe your ideas just as easily. Regardless of the risks, try not to deliberate or worry excessively. I'm sure you are busy too, and you have better things to do. You may wonder why the ads are made visible to the public at all. The sites make all ads available in partial form so that unsubscribed visitors may, by viewing samples, be enticed to become members. Everyone starts as a browser and needs something to browse before making larger decisions. As you browse, you will surely see that invariably, advertisers get some responses that are outrageous. Offers to write a 100-page book in a day for a few hundred bucks. At this stage, just ignore those, and know that regardless of a few sour grapes, overall the system tends to work. You can move things along a little in terms of trying to get the type of responders you want. Obviously, offering a legitimate amount of time and pay is one way to attract a good ghostwriter. On Elance, you can peruse the database and select certain writers to invite them to bid on your project. On Guru, you can screen out certain types of people from the list to bid on your project. Once you get to the list on Elance, follow the site's instructions to invite certain people to bid on your project. You can either browse through the list line by line and select candidates you like to invite, or you can do a site search for certain types of qualifications. There's usually a limit on how many freelancers you can invite to bid. 10 or 15 writers should be plenty though. The sites limit invitees to keep advertisers from mass inviting the whole list. That would serve no purpose since ads are viewable by all members, but some advertisers would surely mass invite to be more visible than competing projects. Limiting invitees takes care of that potential problem. On Guru, you can limit your ad allowing only writers with certain qualifications to bid. Because Guru's database is so large, most advertisers screen out writers who do not have paid memberships. This, in theory, eliminates fly-by-night writers who are not willing to pay or to maintain a monthly subscription to the service. On Elance and Guru, most ebooks are outsourced for a flat fee. When I say flat fee, I'm talking about the money you offer to pay the ghostwriter, as opposed to the various percentages and fees taken by the database site. If you choose to, you may, in addition to the flat fee, offer a ghostwriter a per sale percentage. This is a good-hearted thing to do, since the writer created the work. Even ghostwriters have to live. You are never under any obligation, and most ebook owners don't offer percentages to their ghostwriters. You will be required to use the payment processors on the sites, so that they can take the appropriate percentages, and also so that the writer is somewhat guaranteed to receive proper payment. For example, on Guru, some writers may opt only to receive payments through an escrow plan. By doing so, they require that their clients have the payment available in full in an escrow account. Although actually payment is not transferred until agreed terms are met, the money is sitting in the account, to be paid upon completion. Having the money sitting in escrow builds a writer's trust in your ability to pay. You also may, if you wish, offer credit to your ghostwriter in your ebook. It's occasionally a common practice with paper books, and you may do the same in your ebook. I recommend it, because it's a nice thing to do and will please a good writer who you want to remain on good terms with. Here's how you do it without flat out telling readers your book was ghostwritten. 1. Thank them by name in an acknowledgement paragraph. Don't mention what exactly you're thanking them for. Your acknowledgements paragraph can be in a foreword, an introduction, or near the end of the ebook. 2. Include the ghostwriter name in the byline in an inconspicuous location in the beginning of your ebook. Don't do this on the cover or in your web sales ad, and don't make it prominent. In small print underneath by your name, include the phrase "with Gary Ghostwriter." 3. Instead of using "with," use "as told by." I wouldn't go as far as to say that giving partial credit is a universal practice, especially with ebooks, but it is done, so you might want to think about it. I do it sometimes, but not all the time with ebook ghostwriters. I decide based on the quality of their work, the possibility of follow-on ebooks, and whether or not the readership would be compromised in any way. Here's why I'm telling you the partial credit stuff. Even though it's something you can offer that is often considered as good as compensation, I do not recommend that you offer it outright on the database sites. Regardless of what other advertisers are offering, only offer partial credit if the final product warrants it. I implement partial credit on a case-by-case basis, and never offer it to an unknown writer up front. Alternative to writer banks, frankly. Placing your project ad into a large database like one on Elance or Guru and getting competing bids is the most efficient way to find a ghostwriter. However, I would be remiss if I didn't at least let you know that there are some ghostwriters that you can hire directly. I mentioned you could look around in writing organizations, but also, you can go directly to any of the websites listed in the last section of this book. You will need to do your homework, check references, etc. on any of these ghostwriters, just as you would with ghostwriters on the database sites. To find more individual ghostwriting websites, search the internet for ghostwriting service, or ebook ghostwriters. If you hire directly, you will save yourself the finder's fee charged by the database websites. However, you will not have access to the competitive marketplace and the ranking information from the large sites. On Elance and Guru, after projects are completed, many clients provide some very valuable and useful feedback on their experiences with the ghostwriters they hired. This feedback is available to future clients and people who are placing ads. Individuals and companies who provide ghostwriting services but are not bidding for your job through Elance or Guru may charge flat fees, percentages, or per-page rates. Some require partial credit in the ebook. Some of them advertise rates that are rather high compared to the ghostwriter banks, but you may also find some that are comparable, such as www.truetalentmedia.com. Talk to individual site potential ghostwriters online to find out their fees, experience, and such. If one can't help you, he or she may be able to direct you to someone else in their line of work that can. However you go about finding one of the many ghostwriters that are lurking day and night, for efficiency's sake, do use the internet. Post your project on Guru or Elance or both, or initiate contact with an online ghostwriting service. Once you start getting bids from the banks and/or pricing and service information from the individual ghostwriting services, you'll have decisions to make, and I'll tell you how to choose a writer in the next chapter. Some tips on posting your ghostwriter wanted ad back to the database sites. Posting an ad is simple once you have your topic or title selected. You want to include some particulars, but not all of them at this stage. Once you negotiate terms with a writer, then you will of course put every item that you require into a contract. Your ad should include the following items: 1. Short description of the project. A few lines at most. 2. Maximum amount you are willing to pay. Writers can bid lower than this, but they cannot bid above your maximum offering for your project. 3. Date you will close bidding on your project. Close bidding in a few days or a few weeks. Don't leave your ad lingering on the site too much longer than that, because it loses momentum. Besides, if you are not getting responses you like, you can always place another. 4. Deadline the ghostwriter will have to meet. Give the writer a month or 6 weeks if you can. But, if you really need an ebook in 7 days or less, then specify that. If, for example, you'd like to have an ebook written on the subject of how to homeschool your gifted child, here is some text you might include in your ad. 1. An 80-page or longer ebook covering successful homeschooling techniques to use specifically with gifted children. Research to be done by the writer. 2. Revisions if necessary. 2. Maximum acceptable bid, $1,200. 3. Close bidding date, December 5, 2005. 4. Will need completed book within 21 days of job start. Tip: a good length for a for sale ebook is 80 pages. Other common lengths are 40, 60, or 100 pages. To specify that you'd like an 80-page ebook, require at least 80 pages, or 80 pages plus in your post. A free giveaway ebook used to market other products or services may be any length. You can specify any other parts of the book you like, but keep your list of requirements relatively short. For example, you may specify that you need a glossary chapter or that you will need drawings and/or photographs included. For an ebook on how to tie your own flies, you may ask that the ghostwriter provide drawings, or you may provide the drawings yourself. The former is easier for you, but will probably drive the cost and delivery time up somewhat. When you come to an agreement with a writer, you will naturally provide all the other details he or she will need to complete the book. He may need to know what font you would like or what personal details you want included. It is a good bargain to pay around $1,000 to get an 80-page ebook ghostwritten without drawings, photographs, or cover art included. It is possible to get good ghostwriters sometimes for a tad less. If you offer to pay a maximum of $150 for an 80-page book, you will not likely get a ghostwriter who knows what he is doing. You can advertise a maximum of $1,000 for a 60-page ebook, and you will get some legitimate offers in the range of $500 to $1,000. Although you don't want to pay a huge amount more than necessary, I do recommend that you offer and pay an adequate amount to get a good ghostwriter. It's worth it. My rule is for a simple ebook, I will pay up to $1,500. I add more if drawings or photographs are required or if length is greater than 80 pages. My math indicates that I will need to sell roughly 100 ebooks to recoup that money. No problem, since I'm working the marketing and sales end instead of writing the book. And my sales are much higher, generally. Tell viewers what kind of qualifications you are looking for. Either make the selection on the screen by clicking on the categories provided by the service, or indicate clearly in the text of the ad what type of person you are looking for. You will also want to indicate that you may require that the ghostwriter make revisions after you review the ebook. Note this in your ad as well. It is okay to indicate that you would like two sets of possible revisions to be included in the bid. When you negotiate the final terms with the writer, you can specify what types of revisions are included and the time frames for them to be done. One thing you do not want to do is to change your mind on what you want after you have already posted your ad. Although posting is free on the ad sites, if you make changes or otherwise renegotiate on terms already established, word will get out. Besides, it's just not a good idea. It wastes your time. A great way to make sure you've included all necessary details, but have not gone overboard with too much detail in the initial stages, is by browsing other ghostwriter wanted ads, Elance or Guru. In 10 minutes, you'll be able to jot down your ad by using one of them as a template. Posting projects, or running your ad to find a ghostwriter, requires a little bit of reading time on your end. But once you learn how to post ads the first time, you can repeat the process over and over again with little effort whatsoever.